Because you're famous, you still come to the park. Why do you come to the park when you're famous? Because when normally when someone's famous, he does videos on his channel. Why are you coming to the park and doing videos on other people's channel, and other people are getting the content, they're getting the money, for example, they're getting... So why are you doing that?
Well, since you're asking me a genuine question, I'll try to reply and hope it is genuine.
Yeah.
Well, obviously, look, when we in the public scene, we have personal intentions ourselves, yeah? Okay, and by the way, I have a lot of problems with you, but that's a different story. I just want to make that clear, because I don't want to seem like we are cool, because, you know, I believe you in Swat Sahab.
No, I said, hold on.
I'm saying we have our differences, so I've made that clear to you.
And so the ones that are for the profit.
The question that you're asking me, yeah, okay, is that, the question you're asking me is, obviously I suffer from my intentions sometimes. So obviously I have to come, I have certain methods in place that I do to fight my own nafs, my intentions. So if coming here, I don't need to bring my own camera, let people record, because it's not exclusive to me. The dawah is not exclusive to Ali Dawah, do you get it? And like a brother here says, you know, Ali Dawah needs dawah.
And he's right,
I do need dawah. I think only somebody who's arrogant would say he doesn't need dawah. I personally believe I need dawah. You need dawah as well, yeah?
Okay, you say, okay.
Do you not need dawah?
Everyone needs dawah.
So alhamdulillah, so that's the reason I come here.
Wait, one second. I just wanted to see.
You asked me a question about
No. Okay.
So that's the reason I come to the park. It doesn't matter who records, what records, I don't care who's on what, whose channel. Inshallah, if I might accept one of those, inshallah.
Okay, Ali, I've told you before in front of
Ali Dawah. You need to share the video, man. Share some love. You got lots of subscribers, man. Like Maldini is your Muslim brother, isn't
it? I'm more famous than him now. Because I'm on KSI, Logan Paul, Drama Alert, Keemstar.
Is he your Muslim brother?
John Cena. I'm more famous than him.
Is he your Muslim brother? Ali, answer the question.
Answer the question right now. Am I your Muslim brother?
Do you
you didn't answer.
Can I answer?
Okay.
Because I believe that can make you a Muslim.
Let me answer the question. When I answer the question, now we've got a good question. Reels here. TNT. This is going to be sick, bro. Listen to what I'm going to say. Ali, that way you got nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. You are with me now. I've showed you all this love. Look, I've showed you all this love. I've showed you all this love. I've told you I love you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, when you love someone, tell them. Yeah. I've showed you that I love you. I told you I support you. I told you I'll back you in a beef. I said to you, you're my Muslim brother. And then when your mom. Oh. When did I insult your mom? Hold on. Hold on. He just slandered me. Astaghfirullah. I'm not trying to say it in a bad way. Okay. You just said that I insult. Did you hear me insult?
Did you
insult? No. If I say to you, you insult. Okay, first of all, did you hear me insult? Did you hear me for you to say that in front of everyone in the camera? I'm asking you a question, Habibi.
I haven't heard you.
Okay, if you haven't heard me, why are you saying that in front of everyone?
Because
that's a big thing to say. Imagine I come up to you and I say, did you never heard me say
it?
That's hearsay. That's
not admissible.
All right,
I'm here under our organization, Salam.
All right, big up, yeah? Assalamu alaikum, alaikum salam.
One of our aims is to change the whole, you know, this ego.
Yeah, but don't run away from the question. All right. Because you just said I dis Aisha. You know, man get mad over that.
Let him talk.
No, if you said that.
No,
that's what they're saying.
Because as far as I know,
you have to fear Allah. Imam Ali said before, between truth and falsehood, there's four fingers.
So therefore, I'm here, I represent my organization. So there's certain things that I can talk about and not talk about. Right. So today I came here because I believe as Muslims, we need to have good akhlaq, good adab towards one another. Yeah. So that's the reason why I've come here. Actually, we're starting something, a new initiative called Salam Corner. We're going to be coming here next week onwards, inshallah, and talking to Muslims and non-Muslims and helping them with their doubts, whatever it may be. So what we're trying to do is trying to change the vibe of the park because it's become hostile, it's become violent.
But you just made that.
If someone's watching this and they come up to me and say,
I'm Mo, and then I get shifted. I get splashed on here, it's going to be your fault. No, you know that, innit?
I got one question for Ali.
Let me ask you
one question after Ali.
Do you insult? Now
you're asking, but before you ask me, you said to me, you do it.
Because we had a discussion, remember? And
did you hear me say it?
But
did you hear me say
that she's the enemy of the process? Remember, we had a discussion.
Okay, now, can I clarify?
Sure.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد I had a discussion with you over there. I said that there was a battle called the camel, the jamal. This is in history in all Muslim books. Aisha went against the Khalifa of the time, which was Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, Amir al-Mu'mineen, the greatest man after the Prophet. And that time, maybe 50,000 Muslims died from Sahaba, both sides. Now, 50,000 people died. What if, when someone dies, if you kill one person, it's a big sin, because killing is one of the biggest sins in Islam. So what we see, it doesn't matter if she's a wife of the Prophet, because Lot has a prophet whose wife is in hell. Noah had a prophet whose wife is in hell, and Allah is saying this in the Quran. And Allah also threatens the wives of the prophet in the Quran. So we say, just because she's a wife of a prophet, because the prophet had 9 wives, it doesn't mean that she can make wars and 50,000 people die and she's the best person. On what basis is this? And Allah has threatened the wives of the prophet. He said, I will bring the angel Gabriel, the angel Michael, all the angels in the sky against you if you try and violate the holy prophet Muhammad. Now, 1 second, can I finish? 1 second, because you sounded me. When this battle happened,
I didn't ask for history.
You have to know your history. Because if you come to Islam and you don't study history, and you're going to be jahil and then join ISIS.
I'm sorry.
One second, brother. No, brother. Because you just said a big brother. I love you, bro. I don't hate you. I'm not. When I'm answering you, I don't.
I went to pray.
Brother, you started talking about salam. We love salam. We're going to talk about your thing.
But yeah. I came to pray.
Yeah.
I finished my prayer.
Yeah.
I just want to go and do da'wah.
Okay, but
1 second.
This is da'wah, bro. This is da'wah. What do you mean it's not da'wah?
So, if you 1 second, I'm going to walk off.
Okay, yeah,
okay. I'm just saying again. I came to pray. Yeah. I prayed. Yeah. I'm just walking to give da'wah.
Yeah.
I'm here representing our organization.
Habib, I have
so
got no
there's
problem.
Certain things I can't talk about. I'm asking you kindly. You came with your hand around me. You said you love me. I said, okay, no problem.
Bro, you said to me in front of everyone.
Okay.
You said, you diss my mum.
Just to clarify.
Just to clarify. That's not say to take
can,
that back.
Can you say Aisha and
can you take that back what you said?
Okay.
You said I dissed your mom, take that back. Because I didn't diss your mom.
I'm gonna take it back.
Say that Modi did not diss your mom.
The Prophet's wives are our
No. Answer the question properly, Habibi. Don't be like
this. But
don't be upset with me. I'm the one that should be upset with you.
I'm saying, can you say Aisha may Allah be?
Okay, can you take back what you said first?
I will take back if you say this.
Okay, why are you putting hold on? So if I don't say what he's saying,
you're even scared to say.
No, hold on. Hold on. Okay, I'm not gonna stop you. Hold on, this guy never took back what you said. Just because I didn't say it. Hold on. Why are you walking up? Ali, that way. Hold on. Why are you running, Ali? Ali, don't run away. Oh, all right, let him run away. Let him run away. No. Let him run away. But let me tell you one thing. Just now, look what he just made a point. He said, if you don't say this, I'm not taking it back. What has that got to do with that?
I only wanted to
hold
ask
on.
Him one question, Mo.
Come around
the and run away, man. I just wanted to ask him one question. I only wanted to see his Uber account, man.
No, listen to this. We'll get him Uber later. Listen to what I'm saying. Yeah, let me tell you one thing. That was not a real, what he did was not nice. He just came up to me and said, you did this with no evidence. He's never heard me do it in my life. And then I said, okay, take back what you just said. He said, I'm not going to take it back if you don't praise this person. So if I don't praise this person, he's going to say, because you didn't praise this person, that means you dissed this person. Do you see his logic? That's not fair. The whole world is watching now. Alhamdulillah, there's cameras here. Because if there wasn't cameras, no one would do Islam. What I wanted to say is this. Listen to what I'm going to say.
Talk to them.
I am going to talk to you now. I swear to God now my blood is boiling. But I'm going to be such a nice person because I'm the nicest person. Everyone here is invited for dinner. But I will pay for it. Yeah, listen. Let me tell you, Lassai. Ali Dawah, he could not face me right now. Like, I love Ali Dawah because I love him. He knows this, but I have to say the truth. Because when it comes to the truth, we can't play around. He did not face me like a man. He said to me, I'm repping an organization, I've got a move. What's that got to do? You say you come and give him da'wah. I'm bringing you historical facts. History, you have to, if you're Muslim, you have to read the history. You can't just be Muslim. But ISIS, fuck all that. You read your history, you know what's going on, then you come and talk, bro. Because right now, I said to him, I'm more famous than him now. Because I'm on Drama Alert, KSI, Logan Paul, John Cena, the whole American world's talking about me. So I'm more famous than him. He's not international like me. He's just like in the park. Exactly, you man don't even know him. That's what I'm saying. But he's international in the park only, yeah? I don't care about that. I'm more famous than him. So he's the one that should be, it's like Anthony Joshua against that guy, Ruiz. Ruiz had to come to him, do you understand? But I'm just saying, he has to come to me now. Not I'm going to him, Ali Dawah. Yeah. Listen to this. So let me tell you lot something. Before everyone starts saying, I'm getting bored, get your pens and papers out right now. I'm going to say some mad things I've never said before in this spot. How about that, bro? I'm going to say things right now that people in here are going to get mad.
Tell them again, more.
But even though I'm going to say it, even if I get stabbed, even if I get concussed, he just tried to do a sly one to get me shanked. To get me attacked. You know, he done a slam. He dropped it and he walked up. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to say that to him because I love him. Even though, see how much love I got. Even if someone hates me, I love them. Look at this. I am going to talk now the greatest speech in this park since Modi has ever come. How about that? Exclusive thing. But you don't have to be patient with me. Don't be telling me, oh, I want to be filming over there. You got to be patient. What, this is the, you know how Tan done his, what do you call it? What do you call it, that
manifesto
thing? Manifesto. This is Modine's manifesto. What?
Well, I don't know.
Get ready. Yeah?
Are you ready?
There's, okay.
I'm ready, yeah.
I'm gonna, listen, you ready? Yeah?
Let Ro have it.
Big up.
Listen, I swear to God, God is my witness, yeah? God is my witness, put part two. Now, I'm not joking.
I'm getting it exclusive.
No. I'm not joking with you. I will never chat to you. I will never chat to you in my life. My whole life. You know what I'm saying? Till I die, bro.
Film me.
Yeah?
Everyone.
A'udhu billahi min shaitan rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Because this, I want the world to hear it. The world.
Yo.
Not just one person, two persons. I want the world to hear it, to get pens and papers and take notes. Because I've had enough of people just ignoring, running away, shouting, fighting. Now, I'm here now. Ali Dawa walked away. He walked away. He didn't face me. Yeah. Even though he's the one that initiated the thing. Okay. Listen to what I'm going to say step by step. A'udhu billahi shaitan rajeem. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Imam Ali is the greatest companion after the Holy Prophet Muhammad. Ali is the descendant of Abraham. He's the cousin of the Prophet Muhammad. How many wars? These ISIS hate him, Imam Ali. That's why ISIS was created, because they left the teachings of Imam Ali. That's why there's corruption in the world, because they left the greatest man after the Prophet. I'm going to prove to Shamsi, Ali, Dawa, all of them, that Imam Ali is the greatest man. And wallahi billahi tillahi, they will never be able to bring any evidence to counter what I'm going to say. Anything. Yeah? Listen. Imam Ali, before I start, Imam Ali said, anyone who says the first and the second are greater than me, the first Khalif and the second Khalif are better than me, he should be whipped, the whipped of the muftari, the liar. Man, you understand? That's the first thing. Imam Ali said, yeah? Imam Ali said, I am the Siddiq, I am the truthful one, and I am the Farooq of this Ummah. Anyone who uses this title other than Imam Ali is a liar. The Prophet gave Imam Ali this name. First of all. Second thing, in all the battles of Islam, in all the history, Imam Ali was the bravest warrior. He never ran away. Whereas in Khaybar, Khandaq, Hunayn, Ahzab, all of it was Imam Ali defending the Prophet. In the battle of Uhud, when everyone ran away, when the Sahaba, they didn't listen to the Prophet, he said, stand there, the archers. Have you seen the film, The Message? He said, stand there and don't move from your places. Listen, they didn't listen to the commands of the Prophet Muhammad. They left the mountain, and they went for the war booty. What did Khalid ibn Walid do? He came from the back. It's in The Message. Watch the film. He came from the back and he smashed the Prophet in his head. And his teeth came out as well. The Prophet's teeth came out that day. And on that day, Hamza was killed and his liver was taken out and eaten by Hind, the wife of Abu Sufyan. On that day, on the day of Uhud, they did, and they ran away. They left the Prophet. Only Imam Ali and a couple of Sahabas, they stayed with the Prophet. About five Sahabas only. 1 second. Now, on this day, Imam Ali was defending the Prophet so hard, the mushrikeen, they were coming. Hamza was chopped up. His fingers were chopped up by Hind, the liver eater. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi was left this, and then the verse came down on the Sahabas. Why did you run away and leave the Prophet? The biggest sin in Islam, one of the major sins after adultery, killing, shirk, is running away in the battlefield. Why? Because especially when the Holy Prophet is there.
Brother,
you understand?
Name me the ayah.
I'm going to bring you everything, Habibi. I'm going to bring you everything. There's not one thing I'm not going to bring you. I'm going to bring you everything. Just 1 second. I'm going to bring you everything. But I have to talk, yeah? I'm going to bring ayahs. I'm going to bring hadiths. I'm going to bring everything, yeah?
Forget the hadith. Give me the
Quran. Okay, I'm going to bring you Quran, Habibi. Just wait, yeah, Habibi. Okay? Now, this is some people are going to say, okay, so if there's a beef, are you going to run away? Brother, it's different. If there's a beef and there's a few people, sometimes you can run. It's okay to run. I'm not saying that. But in a battlefield against the mushrikeen, for tawheed, la ilaha illallah, and the Prophet is there, no, it's not okay in this situation. And another situation, yeah, you're with your brethren, couple of men come run up to you, and then there's more than two men, for example. Yeah, come, run. Because this is not a war for the tawheed. This is not the Prophet Muhammad. They say you have to protect him. You can't run in this situation. They all ran. Only four stayed. Imam Ali and three other sahaba, and a woman and two sahaba. The rest ran away. Now this, so, and also when Shamsi says, السابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين تبعهم بإحسان. This is a min tab'idiyah. This is some of them. It's some of them, not all of them. Because the muhajirin, they fighted each other. Akhi, what if they fighted each other?
Is they killed?
They fought each other.
Of course they fought each other.
Tell me.
Okay, do you know the Battle of Yemen? Do you know the Battle of Yemen?
Yeah. What?
Who was that?
Between? Tell me. You tell me. Man.
Okay, Talha and Zubair, whose side were they on? Were they not Muhajirin against Imam Ali? Were they not killed? Yaakhi, just listen.
It was a mistake.
Okay, let me finish. So if two people kill each other, is that they're both in heaven? If I come and I kill you, am I in heaven and you're in heaven? One of us is wrong. We can't both be in heaven, the killer and the killed. You can't say both. If you're saying follow them and they're killing each other, do you understand? The minutes tab'idhiyya, that's why in Surah Al-Waqi'ah it says as-sabiqoon ulaika al-muqarrabun. It didn't say as-sabiqoon min as-sabiqoon. So in this verse, when he says min, he says some of them. Do you understand? والذي, as-sabiqoon al-awloon, only of them. And some of them, and those with وَالَّذِينَ تَبْعُونَ بِإِحْسَانٍ, only those that followed them with goodness. Not everyone. Because the verse of Surah Al-Munafiqin came down. Why did Surah Al-Munafiqin come down?
Who did it come on?
What does the Quran say? إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ. Wait, 1 second. What does that mean, munafiqun? If you do the Arabic language, it means more than two. Munafiqin, that means there was a lot of them.
The Jews were there.
No, akhi, 1 second. They were pretending to be Muslim. Yeah. There was a lot of them. So we can't say رَيَضَى اللَّهَ on these people.
There's so many verses.
Okay,
let me just
finish. Imam Ali, in the day when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi, they were going to kill him, he slept in the Prophet's bed so the Prophet can escape. Khalid ibn Walid and all the pagan tribes, they came to kill Imam Ali. They lifted the gun, then Imam Ali grabbed Khalid ibn Walid's hand, he twisted it. They said, where's your cousin? Aina ibn Ammak? He said, what do you want from him? Imam Ali risked his life and a verse came down on this situation. 300 verses came down on Imam Ali in all the battles. Now listen, in the day of Khandaq, this is a battle. Go to all the Sunni books and the Shia books and every Muslim book. Saudi scholars, they say it in them, even they say it. The day of Khandaq, there was a fighter. He was worth 1,000 soldiers. His name is Amr ibn Abdwud al-Amri. He was a mushrik fighter. He was a giant. This man, the Muslims, they built a Khandaq, means a trench. He crossed the trench. He said, any of you Muslims, come and challenge me. The Prophet said to the Sahaba, anyone who fights this man, even if he is killed, he's going to Jannah. Who's going to fight this man? No one came. Three times. Who's going to fight this man? No one came. The third time he said, who's going to fight? All the three times Imam Ali said, I want to. He said, sit down. The third time he said, I want to fight him. The Prophet said, okay, Ali. He gave him the Imam. Anyway, they fought. And so you can read about the stories in all the Sunni books. Yeah. And Imam Ali, and that day. So, for example, I'm going to give you a verse in the Quran. When it says, فَتَمَنَّوا الْمَوْتُ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Wish death if you're truthful. You understand? This is a verse in the Quran. فَتَمَنَّوا الْمَوْتِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. So صَادِقِينَ is for the person who wishes death. In that time, why did the Sahaba, they did not wish death and fight against that man? Only Imam Ali. So how can you say any other Sahaba is better than Imam Ali? Imam Ali is the best Sahaba. Why? Because how do we judge a person? By three things. By their knowledge, by their bravery, and by their iman. This is how you judge a person. Imam Ali was never ever a mushrik in his whole life. He never bowed down to the idol. That's why the brothers, the Muslims, they say, كَرَّمَ اللَّهُ وَجْهَ. Because he never died to an idol. His iman is more than anyone's iman, Imam Ali. And the other Sahabas, they were mushrik all their life, then they became Muslim. So Imam Ali's iman is more than everyone's iman. His knowledge, Imam Ali read Nahj al-Balagha. Even Umar said, لَوْلَا عَلِي لَهَلَكَ عَمَرْ. If it wasn't for Ali, I would have perished. Umar said it. Imam Ali's knowledge was, and the Prophet said, I am the city of knowledge and Ali is this gate. So Imam Ali is the most knowledgeable about the Prophet. And then the third thing, bravery. In the battle of all the battles, Imam Ali was the bravest, and his sword, if it wasn't for the hit, Jibreel told the Prophet, if it wasn't for the hit of the sword of Imam Ali on the day of Khandaq, he goes, that hit is worth the worship of all the Thaqalain from Jinn and Ins. Because that hit shaved Islam. If it wasn't for that hit, the Mushrikeen would have got rid of Islam. If it wasn't for Khadija's money, Imam Ali's sword, and the Prophet's manners, there would not be Islam.
So, Islam,
brother, Allah, there's reason. The if it wasn't for the Prophet, he would not have sent Islam. Allah, there wouldn't Allah, be Islam. So if you're saying if there was no Muhammad, would there be Islam? If there was no Muhammad, would there be Islam? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. One second, brother. Let me finish what I'm saying. So Imam Ali, the head of Imam Ali on that day saved Islam. There's a book by Ahmed ibn Hanbal. You know who's Ahmed ibn Hanbal? Fada'il al-Sahaba, the attributes of the Sahaba. Two-thirds of this book is all about Imam Ali. Two-thirds of the book. Yeah? So many hadith, so many. I can bring you thousands. All praising Imam Ali. In what way, Shamsi, you're saying, the two Sahabas, they're better than him. In what evidence can you bring to me? I said to you, in knowledge he's better, in iman he's better, in bravery, in the battles he's better. That's how you judge a person. If I say this fighter is getting better than this fighter, what's the evidence, for example? But I'm saying to you, what is your evidence, bro? When the Prophet said thousands of hadith, Ali is the greatest man after me, follow Ali after me.